fresh off of a 1-1 tie with Digital Chaos, and we talked about this beforehand. We set the expectations of MVP Phoenix going into that series. We thought they were the better team, and we even would say after that series, they look like the better team, so we could say that would be a disappointing result, tying with Digital Chaos. They need to be able to do a lot better against Team Secret here, who are obviously a little bit of an albatross in the waiting. Team Secret has a lot of big names on its team, but we still don't know what exactly kind of team performance we're going to be seeing. Are they going to be a top four team, Blitz Dota?
I don't know, man.
MVP.
What is your luck to play?
All right, all right. No preliminary judgments just yet.
I am 2-0-ing any team to bat is putting you in an okay position. They can win this two-game series against MVP Phoenix and go 4-0. They are in a very prime position.
Yes. I was saying overall at TI, but
oh, at TI.
You don't want to take that jump just yet.
That is a commitment that I'm not willing to make off of. Just,
all right.
I haven't seen them play a game yet because we were casting the other game.
I know.
I have no idea how their game's done with DGR. 10 seconds
remaining. All right, a Wisp first pick for Team Secret, or Spirit, and Axe is going to be the response from MVP Phoenix. Seems like Team Secret maybe fallen, taking a little bit of a... Did you see the draft, at least from the Team Secret?
No.
They had Huskar, right?
Yeah, they apparently Huskar'd VGR twice.
Okay.
And they ran the same lineup that Na'Vi did against them at Starladder.
Mm.
So I think not much to draw. It looked like it was just going to be a straight-up win based on the draft alone.
Right.
But MVP Phoenix is a different beast entirely.
You can win the draft and still get whomped.
Yeah, because
by MVP Phoenix.
I actually think MVP Phoenix, their playstyle fits TI. Because TI is a high intensity event. You feel a lot of the pressure, and these guys apply it like crazy. They just run at you nonstop.
They force mistakes out of the enemy team.
Easiest way to put it.
Well, we're going to see what happens in our second banning phase, because you can't really get too much from this 1-2 pick of either side, as we're going to see our second bans coming out. The Morphling from MVP Phoenix, which was the reason that they lost their game number one against Digital Chaos. A critical error in judgment by them cost them game one, despite having a lead. And they're also going to take away the Alchemist, while Team Secret ban away the Lifestealer, which has been what MVP Phoenix seemed to really love. They're still falling back on that Riki Lifestealer combination, though this time around they didn't open up with that. Is there something about the Wisp that prevents you from running that same combination, or is it simply because Riki and Bounty Hit are banned, we don't want Lifestealer?
I think they want to take the Axe just because they can abuse the enemy safe lane, because when you pick an IO, that's the one area where you're a little bit lacking.
Right.
You take the Earth Spirit to mirror the Wisp as well.
Okay. That makes a lot of sense. I like the idea of the offlaner being able to abuse what you know to be a dual lane from Team Secret, but Ancient Apparition banned?
Okay, so here's your awkward situation now. So the MVP Phoenix has banned out the Alk, which leaves the Huskar, Team Secret. So MVP Phoenix, I don't think they necessarily want to pick this Huskar, but they kind of have to be cognizant that there's a very good chance that Secret have just kind of pushed them into a corner.
Yep.
And that looks like what they're debating right now.
Reserve time. So are they going to tank that?
Okay, so they're going to take the Naga. Team Secret, which is another way around it. I know this is a hero that Kyo really likes playing just for what it is, but the pace of the hero might be too slow. If he gets to that ultra late game scenario, though, Naga Siren obviously very good against that situation, but...
Do you feel that Naga Siren is good against Huskar drafts? Would this deter Team Secret from picking up the Huskar now?
I don't necessarily think so, because Naga's a much slower hero than Huskar is.
Yes.
It kind of changes the way that MVP Phoenix as a team will play, just because they're going to get a little bit less aggressive. But this, we're talking as if the Huskar is a foregone conclusion, and it's not.
Yeah, just a potential pick with the Ancient Apparition out of the equation. MVP Phoenix already have a lot of team fight in their hands, while very clearly Team Secret have a movement game in their advantage, both the Wisp and the Batrider. Kind of interesting to see both Team Secret and Evil Geniuses putting a premium on the Wisp now. A new hero, for EG at least.
I think every team more or less values this hero pretty much the same.
Kind of have to now.
It's just one of those heroes that everybody kind of has to learn how to play, and Kunkka going to instead be the pickup for Secret. Very good AoE, and probably the even bigger than that is that all the heroes that Team Secret have now are very good at counter-initiating. We talked about how MVP Phoenix, they're going to be relentless. They're going to crash at you like a wave. Kind of just have to hold the line, wait for them to run out of steam, then blow it all right back.
And Kunkka is somebody who punishes attempts at retreating. MVP Phoenix, they did this last time. It was Lich Lifestealer that they ran as an aggro dual lane when they sensed some weakness in the safe lane, the enemy safe lane, and it seems like they're going to do a similar story here with MVP Phoenix running Lich Axe in their dual lane against Team Secret safe lane.
Yeah. Kind of curious to see Secret do. We were kind of enamored with that Huskar pick just because they had banned out that AA already, but nothing's really been decided to yet. Just because this Kunkka can also be a support in a pinch.
Yeah, he can be the support for bottom lane while the Wisp is supporting mid.
Hey, never mind. Yeah, it was pretty much
good call.
The way that drafting order works nowadays, guys, is when this AA hero is banned, there's only one reason for it. And the way that it normally used to work is before Huskar was prevalent, it would be that you would take the Alchemist as a result, and you could checkmate teams like that. But now, because of this Huskar pick, you take Alk, and they immediately counterpick Huskar. The pace of the game thing alone can just screw up your team. So it's important that you always kind of remember these things when you go into the draft, which is why MVP took so long with that third pick, because if they weren't going to take the Huskar for themselves, they knew it was going to be a position where Team Secret most likely would.
So they needed to be able to draft a lineup that can deal with the Huskar. Do you think Naga Siren, Lich, and Axe is pretty good at it?
I think Axe is phenomenal. Problem though is a lot better when you have these Huskar plus Azul or Huskar plus Oracle kind of lineups where you can just jump in.
There is obviously no real saving grace from MVP Phoenix's supports with the Lich Earth Spirit. A lot of aggression, not any saving mechanism for our Axe.
The good thing though they have running for them is that the Naga Siren Sleep is going to be invaluable this game, just for its ability to reset. If the fight looks bad, they can pop it, but Wisp does kind of throw a wrench into things just because of the amount of burst heal that it gives to Huskar. Wisp allows it so that Huskar can play at pretty much any variable of HP.
As well as X marks the spot. I mean, it now lasts so long that you may not be able to fully escape with the Naga Siren Sleep.
Yeah.
Juggernaut going to be the ban. Obviously, combos really well with the Wisp, with the Huskar. They, MVP Phoenix, are obviously anticipating this Kunkka to be the support. And MVP Phoenix are in an awkward position because they need to be able to pick up their mid, but their bans, not quite sure what Team Secret is going to be running just yet. It's going to be the Death Prophet, so a very clear timing game for Team Secret. A lot of mid-game pressure between the Huskar and Death Prophet. Very clear high ground potential out of that last pick.
Yeah, this is going to be a headache game for MVP Phoenix to deal with, just because I think Team Secret, just based on draft alone, I think they might have had... they might get a little bit better of it all. I think Phoenix, though, they still have a very clear way of winning just behind this Naga Siren. They could just put Naga mid for the dual offlane with something like the Lich Axe, slow down the Huskar as much as possible, and pick something that can go one-on-one with the Batrider, like we saw in the last game.
Yep.
And just hope that the Earth Spirit can make a lot of space.
Well, the Lifestealer isn't in the pool, so that one-on-one matchup that we've seen before is not going to be an option here. You kind of need a kind of aggressive mid-game hero, right? Otherwise, you're just going to get run over by Huskar Death Prophet. You already have Naga Siren for the potential late game. You kind of got to focus on a hero Venomancer that will enable Axe to go ham, and that'll be a Venomancer last pick for MP.
So they still have a lot of magic damage. If he goes Veil, he's going to negate a lot of the effects of that Huskar's natural regen.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm a little bit worried, and they just needed a hero that could, like you said, cover pace for the Naga Siren. Because this Naga Siren, she needs a lot of time. Like, Kyo's pretty much not going to get involved in this game. Most of this is going to come down to, I think, whatever this Earth Spirit and this Menno can accomplish in these team fights.
Is the Huskar and the way they change the magic enough for you to be able to pick up a core like this that is purely magic focused, with also the obviously Veil of Discord having its effect as well?
It's an odd situation because you like the Venomancer because it functions in the same way as the Caudle does, where you can pick it because it'll just hold the line for you and push people back.
Mm-hmm.
And Team Secret have very clear objective here. They just want to push. The one good thing that, or one of the great things that Venomancer does for you is that it cancels the blink from the Batrider, so it makes it hard for him to initiate. It can scout for you. Just kind of does it all, and I'm not sure. Secret are in this position where they have this clear-cut idea of just pushing forward and having this kind of single-core physical damage dealer in this Huskar and the DP ulti. So MVP are going to try to kind of circumvent that, slow down the pace of the game as much as possible, and just make it agonizing for Team Secret to take towers.
Right. All right, well, starting things off, Team Secret versus MVP Phoenix. We already see them going through each one of the heroes of Team Secret. We've got our offlane Bulba, Batrider, Arteezy going to be playing the Huskar in this game. Moving over to MVP Phoenix, Dubu on his famed Earth Spirit, Febby on the much more boring Lich. He's going to have to tank that one for his team. Qo, we talked about earlier, the star of the team, of Naga Siren. Ferev playing the Axe. Ferev's Axe is a terror to behold. And MP on the somewhat questionable Venomancer. We'll see. This hero is sort of how MVP Phoenix will live or die, based on his performance in this game and whether or not the hero is actually effective against Team Secret's strategy.
Sort of think that Team Secret, though. Okay, so it's only gone 9-9. Did win with the last two. We actually saw one of those losses today, or me and Gaz's anyways. Mm-hmm. It was TNC versus Navi. Right. Mm. So Arteezy is gonna go try to play aggressively, and I do like this decision to put Qo in this mid lane. I think MVP just read the lanes really well. They have all three of the lanes that they wanted to get.
They wanted the Axe to match up against the Batrider. You're okay with MP tanking this one at top?
Because who else is going to?
Yeah.
I think if you put Ferev up there, he gets absolutely nothing. But at least with the Venom Wards, you're going to get a decent amount of farm.
Okay.
And you're going to prevent it from people just getting aggressive on you.
Right.
Whereas at bottom, he wouldn't really do too much.
Well, they've already landed two different torrents, but they're going to turn around on our tour here. MP slows him down with the Venomous Gale, and Febby makes his entrance. Unfortunately, he does not have his nuke just yet, obviously going for the level one sacrifice.
Yeah, Arteezy takes some damage, but he should be perfectly fine. He's got that wand completed. Highlight Die is going to start making his way up now, and Febby's got to be careful. There's a lot of damage behind this.
Arteezy dropping very, very low, but they're still able to put the pressure on MVP Phoenix and force them back. Meanwhile, mid lane Qo does pick up his level 2. Dubu has been hanging around, looking for his opportunity to jump Eternal Envy's Death Prophet. Nothing doing there, though. And at the bottom lane, Bulba matched up against Ferev's Axe. A lane that should go fine for Bulba, but we'll see if he overextends himself to the Axe at any point.
The Axe is going to get zoned out pretty hard in this beginning phase, just because the sticky napalm is going to make it really hard for him to just run at him. He does have that windlace picked up though, and probably going to try to go for the boots.
So this is potentially Team Secret winning all three of their lanes.
Yeah, just because the Death Prophet is almost never going to lose his lane.
Yeah. Dubu's going to have to make a lot happen to prevent that win though for Team Secret. MP already copping a bit of Burning Spear damage, and as his lane pushes forward, thanks to the creep pull over to the side, he's going to be in a dangerous position. If he extends too far forward, he could very easily give the first blood over to Team Secret.
Yeah, this is a different look than we've seen from MVP. It's not really that flat-out aggression lineup, and they're so much more used to being able to be really mobile in these lanes, but so far we haven't seen it in all top 3 CS right now coming from Team Secret cores.
Push forward, Arteezy plus Pylite Die, the combination of Huskar Wisp is allowing them to dominate this top lane, pushing well past that tier 1 tower and forcing MP out of CS range. He comes forward now, Pylite Die cops a little bit of damage, but he's got a full bottle, so he's okay with that one. This will just give him an opportunity to give Arteezy a little bit of HP.
And three right clicks and Lich is already at 300 HP, does not want to be in this lane, but you can slowly just start to get levels here. And we're seeing that already, as MP's already level 3, Febby's in a similar position, and they are winning this lane as long as neither of them die, but they get caught by the
double torrent. They won't be able to have any extra disables past that. maybe if Puppy was level 2, they could have the X marks the spot and guarantee a kill, but that's just not the case. Puppy has been one hell of a sharpshooter, though, at this top lane. I think he's landed almost every single torrent.
Yeah, he's just trying to be as annoying as possible, make this lane difficult for them up at top. Part's working is they're not really willing to cross this line on the ground just because it's not safe.
Yeah.
If you get caught by the torrent there, you don't have the protection of the tower can afford you. And meanwhile, the Earth Spirit is transferred up.
Two supports of Team Secret will back themselves away. A quick check at the bottom lane. Ferev is doing quite well in the CS now, 20-1 against the Batrider as this lane does start turning to the favor of Axe. Up at the top lane, they start rolling in and will be able to kick back Arteezy. Arteezy turns on to MP with the extra bit of damage, getting able to get that kill to first blood. It goes to Dubu first before MP falls inevitably to the Burning Spears. Pylai die, actually getting a lot of damage on Dubu here, but he gets the roll away and TP's back. They'll leave the lane solo now to Febby.
First blood being so important right there makes that trade well worth it for MVP as both teams lose their core, but more importantly, first blood goes the way Team MVP, and XP just continues to go in their favor as this Lich doesn't really do anything but try to survive. He's even got two levels of the sacrifice, opting to skip the second level that we typically see in Frost.
QO's a pretty happy camper at mid. His CS is not too bad either, 19-6, and he had a regen in his bottle, so he'll go right back up to full with some illusions and some spam out from the Riptide. Make it even easier for him.
Yeah, and he's going to force Envy. Just keep nuking and bottle crow this time around.
They think they're going to be able to get some sort of damage on QO with the rotation across from Kunkka, but if they commit too heavily, they'll stumble into Dubu's Earth Spirit Trap.
Envy's just going to go back, but courtesy of Puppy, who's just going to X marks the spot him. QO's just going to deny this catapult and keep the lane even here. As now we're starting to see a little bit of a lane advantage from MVP Phoenix.
Ferev actually running in range here of Puppy. They're going to go for Eternal Envy, though. They don't really care about the other heroes. The Torrent is going to go down, but they managed to dodge it from Ferev. He's not getting too many spins, though, and now the heal is coming out from Eternal Envy as he starts Spirit Siphoning away. Ferev covering the tracks of QO as they back into their Tier 1. QO trying to dodge some damage here by splitting into the illusions, but it's not enough. The fire burns him away, and Eternal Envy will now seize the opportunity, popping his ultimate. They're going to go for a Tier 1 push.
That was very well done by Secret. They understood that MVP is eventually going to try to get aggressive there. Bulba immediately ditches that bottom lane, understands that it's not worth it just to get a little bit more XP. His presence in this mid lane is going to be a little bit more important, and Brev's first rotation going to be unsuccessful as Secret beat back MVP, and that is a huge kill for them. We talked about how important QO's timings are going to be, and him going down this early on into the game.
They're not getting too much damage on the Tier 1. Eternal Envy, though, is going to get a lot of damage on QO. Ferev managed to get the double call. Now Pylai die. He's surely going to perish after that one. Eternal Envy, the ghost return, healing him up to full, but that means he's now lacking in damage. Ferev is hit by that torrent. That may actually save Eternal Envy, as the slow was just enough. Ferev couldn't get the chop in.
He had the damage for it, too. It's under 170. And well more than enough, as Q is going to pick up that Arcane Rune. And meanwhile, up at this top lane, Arteezy just continues to get free farm. Venomancer unable to do too much on this top lane. They might try to make a move on him, but it would require half the team minimum.
Arteezy's about to pick up his level 6 too, so if they don't actually move some heroes in, I think Arteezy may be able to pick up the kill. Though at the same time, with the wards down, the physical damage that's coming out from them, if he commits that jump forward, he may actually just die to the wards, even if he does kill the Venomancer. I'm not sure if that's fully worth it.
No, and I think he kind of understands that he's playing pretty patiently right now, getting to get aggressive before Pylai Dai gets there. MVP, I'm not around the map so far, but he's just going to continue to farm.
The way they're going to kind of protect MP, they've got Ferev farming the jungle here because they stacked a couple of these camps a little bit. So he's in the lane, but he's not fully in the lane. He still managed to keep up his farm and will be completing a Blink Dagger in the jungle and maybe getting that surprise initiation on Secret that guarantees a kill, or maybe two or three.
That is a very fast Blink Dagger pickup by Ferev. They did a very good job of prioritizing his farm. He, of course, already has that kill. But neither team has too big of an advantage one way or another. MVP has a slight edge when it comes to experience, mainly just because of their Lich. In terms of net worth, barely slides in Secret's favor. And I think Secret's okay with that right now because their lineup was just kind of meant to break even and get as aggressive as they possibly can.
They are protecting themselves against the potential aggression of Team Secret now, right now by grouping up quite a bit, but it does leave something lacking when it comes to farm efficiency. Nobody at that bottom lane as the creep wave pushed into the Tier 1 tower. Team Secret, meanwhile, holding all three of their lanes and even a bit of jungle thanks to Bulba.
They've done a good job of splitting up the farm. Both teams right now just kind of feeling each other out, continuing to farm before they get too aggressive. MVP's timing a lot more obvious as they're waiting for the Axe to get his Blink Dagger.
Come in, and the next minute or so is Ferev. Shows up at the bottom lane to try and complete that and get it from the side shot, perhaps. He's really not risking it.
There's no reason to, especially since you die in this kind of position, this close to the Blink Dagger, it sets your timing back so far behind.
Right.
Immediately you pop out and you don't go for a kill, you just continue to farm.
All things looking relatively even, but this 2-2 start is only a sign of much more to come, as we can definitely see how this game is going to amp up pretty quickly with Blink Dagger coming in from Forev. And MVP Phoenix need to be able to, as we talked about earlier in the draft, create some space for this Naga Siren. But obviously Team Secret's team not lacking in team fights, that's for sure. With both Eternal Envy and Arteezy rocking some very early game aggressive cores. The Chain Frost are going to come out just trying to deal some damage and push back Secret. An unlucky bounce, though, leads to a premature end.
That just kind of
They may
stopped.
Still get the jump, though. This is risky. They're going into an exorcism as well as a Huskar. Ferev has to get the perfect jump, and it may need to include Pylai Dai. Oh, it looks like they'll be able to get the kill on MP, which means at the bottom lane, Ferev desperately needs to make the initiation, but he missed the Cooling Blade! Eternal MP lives, and he's going to survive throw with the Spirit Siphon. Now the turnaround, Arteezy jumps on in, guarantees the kill on Dubu as well, and Team Secret, wham bam, thank you ma'am, they'll take both of those lanes and win them both.
Eternal MP just kind of like shrugged off damage. The Spirits all come back to him at the same time, full HP now, and
that Cooling Blade executes that Death Prophet. That fight looks entirely different at the bottom lane, and them losing MP at top does not matter as much. But the fact that they lost both of the engagements is now going to lead Secret into taking a very large lead.
And now that was the first reveal of the Blink Dagger from the Axe. Secret didn't even have to expend too much effort. They just got kills across the board without having to work too hard for it. It just came in the form of natural tower pushes, and MVP are going to be incredibly disappointed with that result, as their first wave of aggression just completely falls flat on their face. The good news for them, though, is game plan remains the same, right? QO just continues to farm. He'll eventually slow down the pace of the game once he gets this Radiance, but it's not even like Huskar is a very bad late-game hero.
Yeah. We've seen plenty of Huskars go late-game recently. Seemed to be quite the shift. Heroes like Drow Ranger and Huskar, known for their very timed peaks at 25, 30 minutes, are now able to go a lot later game than they used to.
Yeah, and this Huskar is very farmed. Got that Ogre Club completed already. Decide to go for the Dragonlance if he wants. Gives you incredible stat value for the item is, and doesn't even really need more intelligence. Opting to just go for one level of the Berserker's Blood. Said going for the heal. Kind of common, especially if you have a hard save like that Wisp.
Yeah, and a lot of damage over time from MVP Phoenix as well, so we can combat that with the higher levels of inner vitality.
Everybody moving in from MVP.
They are going to have Eternal Envy reaching in from the right side. Looks like they may have just found their pick, though. MP doesn't even have the ultimate just yet, so him dying here isn't going to grant too much to MVP Phoenix unless they can kill Arteezy. They throw a lot of magic damage at him, but it's not even close. They are now going to be chased down, two down, and a third in the wings here. Febby going to be snatched up by Bulba, pulled right back into the exorcism. Three kills and a tower. Team Secret keeping up the pressure on MVP Phoenix, not relenting one bit.
Oh, they did manage to kill Arteezy.
They did.
That was a surprise.
The Venomancer ticks him out.
Hey, that one level of Berserker's Blood works against him. And more importantly, because he's always been attached to that Wisp, they've had to split all this experience. He's not getting that far ahead in that category. And MVP, I mean, I think they're pretty unhappy with how these engagements are going, and it just feels a little bit sloppy because I think this is one of the few times that we see MVP just battle back and get initiated on.
Unfortunately, MP still a little bit lacking in experience. He needs that level 11 so he can get the big ult. Rev is going to be comboed up here by the Kunkka. Not going to be able to make an escape with the relocate in. Guaranteed kill on the Axe. This is the danger of the Swiss lineup with such aggressive cores. Every single time the Kunkka finds somebody with the X marks the spot, it is, unless there's a lot of backup there, a free pickoff for Team Secret.
Yeah, exactly. And MVP right now, it feels like they're doing what most teams do when they're playing against MVP. They're just kind of falling back to the farm game, hoping that the aggression slowly stops off, but Secret, they're just going to try to force the issue.
Ooh, this could be a big kill. Eternal Envy is going to be silenced up, though. Dubu.
Three different siphons.
Holding off. The siphons start laying in. They get the kick in. The nukes. The extra bit. The wand goes out. Eternal Envy slowly living through this. Can he get away from Dubu? He makes it out. The West heal. Now the turnaround. Two down. MP run over by Bulba as well. X marks the spot. Get over here, Febby. Going to make it a quad for Team Secret as he tries in vain to TP out.
Never underestimate
the Death
Spirit
Prophet.
Siphon from That's... Death Prophet. It's the real ultimate from the zero. Do not think that the exorcism matters too much in these team fights. It'll help for sure, but most of the time it's just your team fight pushes. When it comes to these straight on engagements, having three Spirit Siphons like that, that was the key right there. Mm-hmm. As soon as I saw that, I was like, they're not bursting them. They don't have Chain Frost available. There's almost no way that this is going to happen, but MVP.
And another kill for Rev.
All right, they're just getting sloppy now.
They surely are. There's not much vision down from MVP Phoenix, but Ferev should still know there's a possibility they were just in that river area. They're going to be looking for more pickoffs. There's no reason not to with the Kunkka. NT gets caught out by the Torrent.
This is honestly starting to get really rough because MVP, they're giving away these kills.
There's another one. Relocate up to the top lane. QO is forced to use the Song of the Siren.
He doesn't have TP though.
He does not, but he won't be chased down or cut off in any way. But still, that's a level 1 ultimate that has very long cooldown. We see here Eternal Levy. He didn't even have the Hood of Defiance yet. It was the little things like the wand. It was the little things like that the raindrops coming into play. And as soon as he got out of reach, they just ran out of steam.
And they all end on that kill way too hard. They weren't 100% ready for it. And
yeah.
Now he's going to pop his ultimate. Going for the Roshan, and we talked about the timing Team Secret would have around this Death Prophet and this Huskar, and probably coming on a lot sooner than MVP expected.
Certainly. For the 20-minute marker, Team Secret could be taking all these outer towers with the help of this Aegis. We'll probably wait until the next exorcism. No need to rush things too much. Another Hood of Defiance coming in. This magic damage of MVP Phoenix being very limited is now a completed pipe from the Death Prophet. Loving these item choices from Team Secret.
It's just team oriented right now because they understand that Team Secret, they want to be the aggressors. They want to just flat out push. The fact that kills are being delivered to them in the midst of that push,
mm-hmm.
that has to be the happiest sign for them. They're just like, okay, we didn't actually expect you guys to do this because you have a Naga Siren, but I guess we'll take it.
Now this Veil of Discord, not going to leave the same kind of punch you would have hoped for the Venomancer against all this magic armor. Even the Radiance is going to be looking rather lackluster for the Naga Siren when it comes up. They managed to get the grab though, and the call in return, but still, the fight right outside the tier 3 is not going to be saving grace for MVP Phoenix. Rev runs forward, hoping for the lucky spins, but no such luck. MVP Phoenix dropped 2, and Team Secret continue their march forward on the tier 2s. Artur dropping a bit low, not going to drop his Aegis though, not yet.
Now MVP is more or less all in committed for
another X, another pickoff. MP, no way out of this one. MVP Phoenix incredibly sloppy. This is not the team that we saw just one series ago.
And it's not just that, you got to give credit to Team Secret. This kind of aggression is usually what MVP does to other teams. So they're not really handling it quite well as up at top. They're
now
even going to find QO.
Still 30 seconds left on that Song of the Siren. He did manage to buy out the Radiance just before he died. But as we were talking about earlier, this Radiance is not going to be a big game changer against all this team fight oriented items picked up by Team Secret. They're still going to be able to easily tank through that Radiance burn.
What about Secret right now if they just decided to push in mid with this Exorcism? There's not a whole lot set up right now from MVP, and to Sagus,
oh,
and now
no.
they're just gonna
they get a pick off too. This is gonna look even worse for Rev. Already down to half HP. It's not even a contest. Team Secret rolling over MVP Phoenix in this game number one and will seemingly take a lane of Rax unless they can do something amazing here with the Naga Siren coming back up.
This has been absolutely brutal. Team Secret are playing so efficiently. They're backing each other up. This kind of teamwork, and that's what it is. It's more than individual skill right now for Team Secret. It's just they have better teamwork. MVP look like the team that are trying to rely on their individual skill to make plays, but they're just getting so far behind. You notice bottom, Kyo doesn't even bother sending illusions in this mid lane. There's just no point. They're gonna die so fast.
Clinical precision from Team Secret as they execute their strategy to a T, 19-4 at 19 minutes. And they get the full efficiency of this Kunkka as well. They're going to send some heroes back, heal up. They almost have a completed heart. QO forced into another Song of the Siren. His team's coming in, but they're not going to be fast enough. Now they're going to have to relocate, but the call is there, and this looks nasty. Chain Frost, RTZ not going to die to the Culling Blade. They needed that extra movement speed to get out of there. MVP Phoenix trying to extricate themselves away from this team fight. They've already lost one, and now they're going to get picked. Puppy, he returns QO from whence he came straight into the claws of the Huskar. Team Secret grab another one. They blink forth, pulling MP back. 21-5, make it 22. Team Secret knocking on the doors of another lane, it seems.
I have to wonder if another team is going to give up Huskar, especially after seeing three games in a row of it and how dominant Team Secret can be with this hero. Mm-hmm. And I think this is almost all just Puppy. His Kunkka, not just his Kunkka play, but this draft alone, how he drafted MVP into the corner. We talked about how we saw the Huskar pick coming. MVP themselves couldn't really take it with what they already had. So Secret are like, okay, we'll take it for free. Now you're in a position where Team Secret just rolling over MVP, and this has got to be scary for the other teams involved because it's like Team Secret are just going to get off to an early 3-0 in this group.
Very early satanic for RTZ. The sustain game is strong for Team Secret between the Wisp and Lifesteal, Spirit Siphon. All these things. They've got the top three net worth right now. MVP Phoenix. They need some sort of miracle just to be able to buy themselves 10 more minutes in this game, let alone a full comeback.
I believe that Secret probably just go for it again. They've got the exorcism available, all the items that they need. I mean, their pilot die's got a hood. It's not often you see him this farmed in a short period of time. And the Naga Siren, you always think of her as delaying games, but she needs more than just a Radiance and 1,000 gold at 21 minutes.
Yeah. And now a Blink Dagger for the Kunkka. They've already caught their fair share of heroes with the X marks the spot. Blink Dagger, this game becomes all the more dangerous for MVP Phoenix. They always have to kind of second guess their positioning, knowing that at any moment they could be slightly off and will be punished immediately by Puppy's Blink Ford and X. RTZ, not giving a damn about creeps, about towers, about heroes. He is currently standing on the high ground of the Radiant base at 22 minutes in by himself. His team not really that close to him, just in tether range, that's all. Because he's so tanky, he's got the lifesteal to be able to fall back on. He knows he's safe.
Looks like Secret, they're just pushing in on the lanes right now, applying as much pressure as they possibly can. Probably decide to go for this range Rex as well.
Might as well.
It's a free tower in terms of gold for all of them.
That deficit grows larger and larger. MVP Phoenix just going to stand and watch. Song of Siren goes down. QO still does not have a TP. He's going to be punished by the relocate again. QO, he jukes downwards, but he's still going to be run down by Bulba, slowed down by the sticky napalm. He's not making out of this one alive. MVP Phoenix, I mean, even just being outside of the base without a TP, that is, I would say, almost unacceptable.
Now, they're just being picked apart. Yeah. I think MVP is trying to make whatever they can happen, and that does require you to farm a little bit greedier than you normally do, but the amount of times that I've not seen QO punish this hard.
MVP Phoenix seem to be a whole different team once they're the ones being pressured like Team Secret are doing expertly.
Puppy again.
Torrent, no follow-up though. They don't want to dive in that deep.
It looks like they are waiting for Roche to spawn. They just don't want to give MVP any avenues back into this game, especially when they've got a Roche on.
Yeah, that's smart. If they push high ground right now, they get rebuffed. Maybe some sort of axe call happens and the team fight goes the way of MVP Phoenix. Not only do you have the potential for a huge net worth swing back to the favor of MVP.
Oh, now they go for it, though.
Okay, gonna risk it. But they got almost every advantage in the world they could possibly need. And Aegis almost seems like overkill at this point. Eternal Envy puts himself on the far right side, allowing Arteezy to be the one to tank everything. They don't want to allow Farav the opportunity for a two-man call, but on the side, they've just found QO. They manage to pull him back to the right side. They are going to make their initiation. They get the call out and will be able to eliminate Arteezy. They get the extra movement speed, stay ahead of the boat, and Eternal Envy, while he chases away MVP Phoenix, his exorcism is fading, and he will have to back up.
Don't think Secret are going to be too happy about that trade.
Certainly not. That now means a blade mail for the axe. We'll need a lot more damage coming out from that initiation of Farev. Team Secret, though, can still play it safe. They can hold around the Roshan pit until Arteezy's back up.
They probably just engage in open ground if they want. As Team Secret, I mean, they're far enough ahead. So right now, MVP just trying to get whatever farm they can. Unfortunately for them, their key hero has now died 6 times without a single kill to his name. And Envy might actually get caught out here. He does have a lot of spirit siphons.
He has Pylite die, but the double silence gets laid out for Ev. He's going to go straight for that wisp. They're looking for the Culling Blade. Oh no! A little bit of magic wand stops that one. Another missed Culling Blade. They needed that movement speed too. They're still trying to chase down Eternal Envy, but they actually back themselves away, realizing they're in a bad spot. They're chasing too far. Team Secret were ready for the punish. They even threw out the buyback on the Wisp. They were ready to go with a TP in, a potential relocate forward with maybe a Huskar.
Again.
Oh, QO.
No boat commitment, though. He's trying to fake him out.
He's got some of his
team behind him.
Now he's got the Arcane Rune. Okay, QO, he gets off the ult. So he will be able to escape from this trap that Puppy set up, unless they can get another X. He's trying to blink forward. He's almost got it, but not quite in range in time.
I don't think he expected the back-to-back X marks the spots.
That is absurd.
Yeah. Okay, now
4 second X, and then you're stunned for 1.5 seconds of Torrent, and then X marks the spot is back up again.
So now you definitely wait for the next Roshan.
Yeah.
They're just going to farm around this area, deny MVP as much farm as they possibly can. MVP doesn't even bear worth repeating, just going to go for this fight, though. They still have to wait for the Naga to get more farm. But...
and now their rotation was just scouted. The scan was used. And Team Secret, no. They're letting Arteezy be the bait. They're saying, MVP Phoenix, if you want to force a fight by initiating on the Huskar, who's got Dragonlance, Armlet, and a Satanic, and a Wisp behind it, by all means, go for it.
Absolutely no reason to do that. And the unfortunate part, though, is that MVP desperately want to fight in that open territory so that their Lich Chainfrost can do a lot. They don't want Secret to just pop the Exorcism in front of their base like they have been doing so far in this game. Especially with an Aegis, I don't know if they can take down this Huskar twice. They're going to be forced to right now.
Do you think they should just? I mean, it's damned if you do, damned if you don't.
Yeah.
Which one do you think is a better option? Should they have tried to force that Roshan fight, or is the high ground defense better for them?
I think if you have the smoke, you go fight. If you don't have the smoke, there's nothing you can do about it.
Okay. A smoked up Puppy. Solo smoke Kunkka could find the Naga Siren. She does not have Song of the Siren back up just yet. If Puppy successfully scouts this one out, gets the XQO. Oh, he just got it. He just got that ult back up. He's gonna have to TP away. Is it gonna last long? The flame break lands! Bulma to the rescue. QO down for the count.
But you sneaky guy.
And this means even if MVP Phoenix somehow survived for another 20 minutes, this Naga Siren will still pale in comparison to the Naga Sirens that we've seen that have managed to pick up farm via their split pushing. He's just dying too much, and this Huskar is getting way too much.
This is honestly just a masterclass in shutting down Naga.
It is.
Every single turn that she's gone to, Puppy's been there. If not, the rest of Team Secret backs him up immediately. You see that TP barely canceled by that flame break. Kyo's just got to be frustrated out of his mind right now, but not too much he can do anymore.
Tier 2 will fall, no contest from MVP Phoenix, as they still need another 5 seconds for that Naga Siren. If they have Song of the Siren, could they ever try and initiate with that to set up the Venomancer ult and the Frev call and that sort of thing?
Potentially. I just don't know if they have enough damage to kill both the cores from Team Secret.
Yeah.
It's not like these guys are scaling forward very much on the side of MVP. And the rest of the heroes are the biggest concern right now. Venomancer kind of getting close to his Aghanim Scepter. But I don't know how much Frev can make in terms of impact in a game like this, just because they've always got the counter initiation of the Torrent plus the boat. More importantly, they have so many teamfight items on the side of Team Secret. They've got four staffs, hoods, pipes,
now lads. Now. Every little aura.
Oh, look at
Kyo. Could want.
He is so afraid. Yeah. He's not even willing to chance it anymore.
He doesn't even have the Manta yet.
He's just so afraid. He's just sending in illusions. Pull me 8 times. Shame on who?
Team Secret playing it slow right now, not trying to go high ground like they did earlier that bottom lane, and kind of made a trade that wasn't real worthwhile for them at 1-for-1. They're just growing their leads, and they don't really have much to worry about. As we were talking about earlier, there's not some big impending late game from MVP Phoenix that will turn this game around. Naga Siren is already looking poor enough and may not be able to actually beat out a incredibly farmed Death Prophet in Huskar, as yeah. is.
Kyo's gonna try though, and he's still getting a good amount of farm right now. Things aren't completely out of the realm of possibility just quite yet. He still has 12k net worth. He's gonna get this bottom tower as well, or so he hopes.
Can't even stick around. He's afraid that maybe a Kunkka's gonna TP down there. He'll get caught. So I wanna risk it until he goes back in for the last hit, and misses that one. Team Secret.
They're gonna push the pace. This might actually just force QO back.
Yeah, they very quickly go straight uphill, pop the ultimate into the Exorcism, and the call goes down for Ferev. They're getting a lot of damage in return with the Blade Veil. Not even close. They take out the poor Death Prophet without any save from Team Secret. A buyback immediately from Ferev. They need all the help they can get, even if it is 4 versus 5. We need this extra hero to be able to stop RTZ. There goes the call. X marks this spot, making sure that Artur doesn't stray too far. Puffy making sure his carry player is locked in. There goes the Satanic, healing him back up to full. Still has an inner vitality as well as a Wisp. Ready to go for round 2 and round 3. Death Prophet, meanwhile, is going to start teeping out to mid lane. Artizi dropping a little low. They are going to be able to get the X onto Ferev here. Popped him back into the torrent. This will give Artizi enough time for the dieback. Kills Ferev and continues to beat on this melee Rex. Now it's going to be Dubu's turn to get pulled into the flames. Bulba eats him up. Godlike for him, and now MVP Phoenix running out of heroes. QO runs into Eternal Envy there, while RTZ jumps forward onto MP. Gets off a pretty good ultimate, landing on a 3, but do they actually have the damage? Just seems like they're gonna run out of steam as MVP Phoenix heroes are falling left and right. RTZ quick hit 1, 2, 3, and the Satanic heals him back over half HP. Looks like Bulba may end up dying. Nope, not even Bulba's gonna die. Healed up, Glimmer Cape, and sent back to base. Artizi sticks around inside MVP Phoenix's base, establishing his dominance.
Yeah, unfortunately for MVP Phoenix, did lose 3 heroes there, but they didn't lose their Naga Siren, and more importantly than that, no racks were taken, because QO just cut the creep wave every single time. Mm-hmm. He understands there's no way that we're going to win this straight-up teamfight. The rest of the creeps now are filtering in. They've managed to survive the Naga Radiance and the split push attempt, and this could just be a second set of racks going down. MVP, no way that they can take this fight. You don't want to give up any more heroes than you already have.
Bulba going in deep, looking for that next pickoff. But MVP Phoenix hiding around the fountain, which just means RTZ will get the free lane. Gonna go for 3 now.
RTZ making his way up top. They've eventually got to take this fight. They know that MVP are in a bad position, though. They don't have that Venomancer ultimate.
Smoke goes down. Maybe they're going to initiate. No, they're actually still going to try and jump RTZ, but he got off the Satanic. Rev, he's not going to be able to bounce enough damage back with the Blade Mail. He'll be pulled back into the ult.
Now QO stuck in no man's land.
No, he already used that Song of the Siren trying to slow down Team Secret, but now he's been caught, hit by the turret, slowed down by the Spirit Siphon. Dubu, he couldn't save his carry. The buyback comes in, but Team Secret, they look healthy as ever. Only Arteezy, around half HP, and we know that Inner Vitality can put in some work quite soon.
He's got the Wisp backing him up as well, and Puppy with another pickoff potential here. Is MP gonna go down without getting his ultimate off?
It is a slaughter fest. Team Secret, one by one, taking MVP Phoenix Heroes, spanking them, sending them back to the fountain, and executing one of the cleanest games we've seen in the group stage so far. 34-8 is our end score at 34 minutes.
Very well done by them. It was just a clinic on how to stop Naga. And Puppy, 5-0-22, did so much work in this game.